What is the difference between squirting, female ejaculation, and coital incontinence? This video will make you an expert on the fluids expelled by women during sexual activity. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. Fluid expulsion is not typically associated with female orgasms, but it is present in some women. Let's start with the most familiar term, squirting. Squirting has gained a lot of attention during the past years. What kind of liquid is this? Basically, it's urine. At orgasm, up to 150 milliliters or more are expelled from the bladder. However, it is not normal urine, but it is somewhat altered, most of the time also containing PSA, the prostate-specific antigen. As compared to normal urine, it is much clearer in color, containing less uric acid, less urea, and fewer electrolytes. In an interesting study on the nature of squirting, they let 7 women with reported fluid emission at orgasm engage in sexual activity in the lab. At the beginning of the experiment, they had to go to the bathroom to empty their bladders. The empty bladder was confirmed by ultrasound imaging. Then the participants started sexual activities either alone or with the help of their partner. When they felt sufficiently aroused, another ultrasound scan was done. Although this was just a few minutes after urination, the researchers noted a remarkable urine production and bladder filling within this short time frame. Then the participants resumed their activity until orgasm. The expelled fluid was collected for analysis. It proved to be chemically altered urine. The observation of an increased urine production during sexual arousal was interesting. I looked into the literature and I only could find one study from 1996 referring to this phenomenon. Female ejaculation is somewhat different. Even here, fluid is expelled at orgasm, but it is much less in quantity and has a whitish color to it. Unlike voided urine, it contains large amounts of PSA, fructose, and glucose. MRI studies identified its origin adjunct to the urethra. It is a structure known by the name of female prostate or Skene's glands. I created a video about it. Here's the link. Not all women possess these glands, but it is estimated that they are present in half to two-thirds of women. Another phenomenon is coital and orgasmic incontinence. I think it is very hard to distinguish from squirting just by medical history taking. Coital incontinence can happen with penetration already and or at orgasm. It is associated with stress urinary incontinence and urgency incontinence. If you don't know what that means, please watch this video. In practice, one will have to do pressure flow studies to find out for sure. Why is this necessary? Because incontinence needs treatment. Here are some videos on the topic. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.